Frank never had a problem being gay. He said his first sexual experience was in the hospital, in that room in where they take the babies, in wicker cribs with their names on them. And he was trying to pull off the knob of this newborn, thinking, I've only got one. I might need a spare when I get home. That's how his mother found him, wanking off a newborn. I was always, my parents weren't big on gay. You remember the ad with the preacher holding the shotgun, standing beside his son, and the preacher says, if I found out my son was gay, I'd shoot him. And the son says, I think he'd like to shoot him anyway. Everything was kind of like that. I had a girlfriend in high school, Donna, but we were friends mostly. And when my parents found out I was gay, they blamed it all on Donna. Like, she was an ambassador from the country of women, and she'd fucked up somehow, so I was never going back there. But that wasn't it at all. I was into boys and numbers. I was going to be the Michael Jordan of sex, the Wayne Gretzky with a hard-on. You know, I was into these group bands. You just slip it in, move along, you know, sort of, you know, keeping score. And then I met Frank. He was older than me, almost 30, and we hit it off right away. He said, are you into fantasy? I do five. I went, yeah. He went, yeah. Coach, rookie, sailor, slut, master, slave, older brother, younger brother, father, son. I picked older brother, younger brother. And, well, we've been together ever since. He told me, a real Canadian can open a beer with anything. And he showed me how to open a beer with my teeth. It took me a while to learn that. Showed me how to build a box kite, fly it over Land's End. He taught me how to make an omelet that would rise the size of a man's head. Frank had a thing for omelets. Guess he got it from his dad. His dad was, he signed on for Vietnam, and he got caught behind enemy lines in Phnom Penh, and he lived on bread and water in a hole in the ground, no light, no food, no people. And you know how he managed? Eggs. He thought of every way you could cook them, bake them, boil, fry them, souffle them. And when he got out, he went to a restaurant. He ordered an omelet, six-egg omelet. He ate it, had a heart attack, died right there in the restaurant. Frank always said it was a good thing, because the rest of his life would have been such a letdown. But he never said it without crying. Then there was Frank's cock. I know size and everything, but it just seemed to fit, you know? For the first time in my life, when he was inside me, I felt like home. I was home for the first time. And you know what they say? You can tell the size of a guy's dick by his hands. Well, Frank had these little pastry chef fingers. I thought it was all padding. I thought he was all padding. You know, you've seen it before, those guys on MTV, those skinny little guitar rats with a bulge that goes halfway down to their knee. You know, courtesy of Kleenex. And Frank didn't need the help. And a lot of guys, if they have a really big dick, they can't get it hard. All they can manage is about half-mast. And believe me, I've tried. I don't know why. Maybe if all the blood went into their cock, it would leave their brain. They'd pass out and die. Don't know. Nobody ever touched me like Frank did. You know? Like it would last forever. We didn't know back then. Nobody did. Frank would have sex the way most people go to the opera. Kiko, you pick a day on the calendar and you go, okay, on this day here, the 14th, we'll fuck. And when Frank said fuck, he meant we'd go at it all day. The doors closed, the phones jacked out, and we'd be listening to the radio, always. CBC. You know Peter Zowski, Morningside, the doo-doo-doo? Well, it was a little hard at first. You know, he's got his tongue around my balls. He's jerking up and down on my stick. And my eyes are rolling back in my head, and all I can hear is, when did you know your blues band wasn't going to make it and you would run for prime minister instead? It was just a little hard to keep my head inside the radio and my balls at the same time. But that was the thing with Frank. He liked to hear the radio waves flowing through him. It somehow connected him to everybody else jacked in across the country. I don't know. Maybe he just had a hard on for Zowski. I never had anyone lick my ass before. I know this is going to sound sentimental, but everyone has their own way of worship.
How much to discover.
We've been together 9 years. In December will be our anniversary, our 10th. But I don't know if Frank's going to be around to see it. He's in St. Paul's. They got this whole ward of guys who look just like Frank. When you walk in, it's a little scary at first. He's lost a lot of weight. He's got these marks on him. That's the Carposi. But when you talk to him, he's inside all that, same as ever. I talked to him this morning. He said, the body does not believe in progress. It's religion is the present, not the future. He's always saying crazy things like that, so nothing's really changed. Except he's dying. And I'm going to miss him. He was the best friend I ever had.